Good morning, everybody. Welcome to the Praxis 55712 channel. I wanted to give you one last shot of these before I set them away for the season and grow them downstairs. This is the butt jalokia. I don't know, whatever it is. It's a ghost pepper. It's the one with the long red tapered peppers. I've been growing this for almost exactly a year now. I grew it indoors until it got big, and this is the one that started the whole series on how to prune your pepper plants for larger yields. Now, I wanted to clarify something. It actually doesn't give your plant bigger yields. It enables your plant to hold bigger yields. But a side effect was it did give my plants bigger yields. But that wasn't my intention when I started pruning this plant. I wanted it to actually hold the peppers and not fall over. But in turn, it actually ended up producing more because it had more growing area. So anyway, that was a huge success. I've shown that a million times. And this one is its twin sister. This is called the Scorpion. And it's impressive in its own right. It has blunt red peppers. And they're hotter than the Jalokia. And this thing, I've done demos on how to actually prune your pepper plant to bring it out and make it into a V formation. A lot of you have followed this advice and you're having smashing success, which I'm really glad to hear. But these two are not gonna go outside anymore because I don't wanna deal with bringing them back in at the end of the season, pruning them back, possibly having bugs or diseases or anything like that. I wanna let these two retire and grow naturally indoors underneath grow lights and just have a good time inside. I have plenty of pepper plants to go outside, so I really don't need to take these out anymore. But, oh, you gotta move. You're a little too big for this. Okay. These two are pepper plants that are going to go outside. And I wanted to do an experiment this year, and it's going to be a side-by-side experiment to put my pruning method to the test. These are both the exact same plant, the exact same age. These are called Italian sweet grilling peppers, or more technically, Nardello. Anyway, whatever they are. They are a pepper that I grew last season in my raised bed, and it was a beautiful pepper. Really, really strong pepper flavor, but not hot. It's actually just a stronger pepper flavor, unlike bell peppers, which tend to be a little bit bland for me. I wanted more pepper flavor without going hot, and these were the perfect choice for me. These grow about maybe 8 to 12 inches long. They're huge. And they kind of curl around, so they're called a horn pepper, but they're a sweet pepper. You can eat them right off the plant, no problem whatsoever. There's no heat in these, but they are wonderful for soups, stews, grilling, scrambled eggs, you name it. You can use it in anything that you would use bell pepper in. They're a wonderful plant. So I gave away some of these seeds this year to some friends to grow themselves, but I didn't really have enough to give to everybody. But what I'm gonna do this season, I'm gonna grow this one unpruned. This one has not been pruned at all. It's just grown naturally from a seed. This one was grown from a seed as well at the exact same time, and I pruned it like I did these two. And I'm going to continue to prune this and to shape it, but I'm going to transplant these both out into the garden and see which one does better or if they do the same. But I'm going to show you the results regardless of what happens. So this is unpruned. This is pruned. Don't know why one is taller than the other. I really generally don't know what's going on. I just accept what's going on and smile and keep dancing. I'm not really much of an expert. I'm more of a mad scientist experimenter when it comes to plants. I just try things. Sometimes they turn out, sometimes they don't. This one is turning out. This one has little peppers all over the place, and I think I'll bring you in and show you a little bit later. But for right now, I wanted to just explain what this is. This is called a peppercini. And it's a mild Italian pickling pepper, the ones that you get in the jars that you eat with sandwiches and stuff. Yep, I grew this last year and it got huge. And I saved some of the seeds and I grew it. Oh, wait a minute. No, I did not save any of these seeds. These are seeds from a viewer who sent me some seeds for peppercinis that are supposed to be bigger than the ones I grew. I don't remember who sent them, but whoever you are, these are your seeds. I almost forgot about that. But anyway, this one is pruned and it's gonna grow wide. So it's a single plant and it's very sturdy and it's already producing fruit. Normally, I don't like my plants to produce fruit until I take them outside because it sucks a lot of the energy out of the plant. So this one decided it wanted a fruit, and I thought, I got 2 more months until it goes outside, why not? So none of my rules are hard and fast, but here, is, oh, don't fall, don't fall. We'll get to you in a minute, okay? All right? This one is going to be the new heir to the throne of large peppers. I don't know how long these two monsters are going to go, but I wanted to grow another one indoors and not focus on the hot, because I'd like to grow something indoors that I can actually eat. And there's no way on this earth you're going to get me to eat these hot peppers. They're just beyond my ability to eat. This one is an Italian grilling pepper, a Nardello. Yes, this is the exact same one as that, only I transplanted this up into a bigger pot. It's been carefully pruned exactly like these, so it has four growing tips coming out of a fork right at ground level. And in theory, this is supposed to get really huge and really fat, and it's going to grow foot-long peppers, and it's probably going to do it by this winter. This is not going outside. This is going to be an indoor plant only. So for those of you who are in apartments, for those of you that do balcony growing that can't have big gardens outside, this one is going to be just for you. I'm going to show you how you can grow a pepper plant indefinitely indoors with a minimal amount of problems in a pot with just potting soil, and it's going to get every bit as big as these, and it's going to be a little bit more impressive because the peppers are going to be a lot bigger than these, and I'm going to allow it to fruit and go nuts. So keep an eye on this bad boy. It is going to be the star of the show someday. It's still tiny, but it's going to grow up nice. This is kind of spooky because it's about ready to fall over, but I wanted it to last just a little bit longer until I could show you. This gangly looking this gangly looking mess is a bishop's hat pepper. Somebody sent me some bishop hat peppers and some seeds, and I planted them. And I demonstrated on this how to do the pruning method for this. And I showed you how it went up, I pruned it, it forked, I pruned it some more, and it was looking beautiful. Well, I was done with the video and I was gonna throw this plant out because I really had no more use for it. It's already done its purpose, but I shoved it to the back of the grow room here and I forgot about it. I literally forgot about it, and it survived. I forgot to water it, I forgot to prune it, and what happened is it flowered. Yeah, it has all kinds of little flowers, and what's even more, it fruited. And I have all kinds of little bishop's hats growing all over the place, but it is time to prune this thing again, because I figured if this thing can put up with my abuse for so long and still put out fruit, you know what? I think you've earned a spot in the voodoo garden up here. And this is going to be upstairs in the grow room all year round, and I'm going to see what happens to it. I'm going to actually do voodoo garden videos all summer long of all the stuff growing upstairs, and then the praxis videos are going to be out in the garden, because during the summer I do the praxis videos with the chickens, with the gardening, with outdoor stuff, and I'm going to keep the voodoo garden stuff for all the stuff growing indoors. So if you want to see stuff growing indoors, tune into the voodoo garden channel. If you want to see stuff growing outdoors, tune into the praxis 55712 channel. But this beauty, it really isn't a beauty, but I like to call it that. It gives it encouragement. Needs to be pruned, and it's been through so much. This thing was pruned, it was going good, and then it got what was called pepper leaf edema. Remember I showed you a close-up, and it was all those little bumps on the pepper leaves, and it makes it look like the plant is diseased, but it's really not an issue at all. Well, it went through the pepper leaf edema, and it started to come back. And then I found out I have what's called white flies, and those are those little tiny white gnats, not regular fungus gnats. These are not even related. These are just a little white ones. If you go like this to your plants, they like kind of fluff up in a cloud. Yeah, I have me some white flies in this grow room, and I can get rid of them if I just wiped out everything with some neem, but then again, a lot of these delicate leaves do not handle being sprayed with neem very well, and white flies really don't do a whole lot of damage to my plants, I've noticed. I read up on them and I've been watching them with a magnifying glass and seeing exactly what they do. What the white flies do is they get underneath your leaves and they suck. Ooh, you're dead. Well, one less white fly in this room. I smash them anytime I get a chance, so I kind of keep them down under control naturally. I just go squish, squish, squish. And they die very easily too. Anyway, they get underneath the leaves and they suck a little bit of sap out of your leaves, and they leave like little tiny dots on your leaves that look a little faded. And it really doesn't do a whole lot of damage to your plants, but the side effect of that is they poop on your plants. Well, they gotta have a tailpipe. And they poop on the leaves, and that's called honeydew. Aphids do it, white flies do it, and the honeydew generally can attract bacteria and harm your plants, but then again, I've never had a problem with it. So I figure if it isn't broke, I'm not going to try fixing it. And the honeydew isn't attracting any kind of harmful bacteria to destroy my plants. This is pretty much a controlled environment. So I just basically, you know, I just brush the white flies away and I really don't worry about it. If I ever have a problem with any kind of bacteria stuff, then I'll deal with it. But I like to be pretty much a low impact gardener. You know, I don't stress over every little thing because it really isn't worth my time. This is supposed to be my enjoyment. So if I'm running around like a mother hen worrying about every little thing, I'm not really enjoying myself. So what I have to deal with, I deal with. What I don't have to deal with, I don't deal with. I just pretty much let these things do what they want. And I just step in every now and then when they need a little bit of help. And that is my way of gardening. Possibly not your way of gardening. I'm sure it's not everybody's way of gardening, but it works for me and it works for my plants. So it's good enough for us. By the way, stay tuned. And I will start doing outdoor videos as soon as the weather warms up. But people have asked me, Ray, why aren't you outside doing gardening? Well, you want to know why I'm not outside doing gardening? Take a look at this. See those little dark spots out there in the snow? Yep, those are my raised beds. And they are a foot tall. So most of them are covered, which means the snow is at least a foot tall. This is why I'm not out gardening, folks. This is spring in Minnesota. Okay, enough of this gardening stuff. Back inside where it's warm. Yep, that's why I'm not outside right now. Now you understand. I'm a northern grower, so I don't get started as fast as some of you southern growers and some of the people overseas, but then again, I'm perfectly happy with that. For me, it's not a contest, it's not a race, it's not a matter of me getting out there to garden so that I can show you how to start yours. More than likely, you're already starting your garden, and that's great because I'm watching your stuff, I'm talking to you about your garden, and I bide my time because eventually spring is going to come, it's going to warm up, and I'm going to be out there in the sun just having a great old time. It's going to happen. But I'm not in a huge rush. I'm having a good time as it is. I think I'm pretty much done here. Thanks for joining me upstairs once again in the grow room. I will be outside eventually. And by the way, if you want to see something a little bit cute and a little bit different, I'm going to be filming a voodoo garden video of something that's going on up here in the grow room. And I think it's pretty cute. If you want to see what that is, tune over to the voodoo garden and check it out. Otherwise, I will see you next time. Have a great day, everybody. Bye. And this is the close-up I promised of the peppercini. Oops, old flowers that need to come off. And it has one, two, three, and then one back here. These peppers, of course, will get bigger as they mature. But as far as keeping them growing and pollinated, all I do is take my finger and go like that. That is how I pollinate the pepper flowers, and it works like a charm. You can do this indoors, outdoors. Anytime you want to make sure that you're going to get peppers, just do that to them, and you'll have peppers just like these. Now, this is going to probably ripen up some peppers before it's time to go outside. So when I transplant this outside, I'll pull off the peppers, then transplant it outside so it'll go through a lot less stress when it's transplanted. Don't these look like little Christmas ornaments? They do, and they're going to turn orange. They're going to turn this most beautiful color of orange. Now, the weird thing about bishop's hat peppers, as opposed to any other pepper that I know of, either a pepper is hot, medium, mild, it's one or the other. Bishop's hat peppers are a duality. What they are is if you eat the lobes, which are, you know, the sections here, they're mild. But if you open them up and eat the pith part that has the seeds, that is extremely hot. So these are hot and mild all at the same time. I'm going to taste these eventually and see what I think of them. If I don't like them, I won't grow them again. If I do like them, what the heck? They may end up having a permanent spot here in the grow room.